The wearing of headpieces stems from our African tradition, where women always had their heads covered. And depending on what you're wearing and what you're going to do for the day, that will determine the type of headpiece that you're wearing. The tête en l'air has the cloth going round in a spiral formation, and it has one peak at the front. That means that my heart is taken. Two peaks, it means that I'm not free, but you can try. Three means, come, let's have fun, but no, you won't get very far. And anytime you see somebody wearing four peaks, it means this person is free, single, and disengaged. Let's get ready to rumble. But for us now, the wearing of the different versions of the headpieces has to do with convenience, has to do with our preferred styles, and even sometimes where in the country you are located. You also have the ceremonial version of the tête en l'air, which is the tête calendée. And why it is called the tête calendée, it's because all of the yellow that you see on it, it is yellow paint that is applied to the fabric before the headpiece is tied. You can have just the headpiece done in the calendée material, or you can have an entire outfit. So for example, this is the fuller that goes with the tête calendée. And if I were to turn it over, you will see what the original fabric looked like before the paint was applied. The only other headpiece that can be worn with your Dwiyèt is called the tête cassée. Now, I know generally people call all headpieces tête cassée, but I'm going to demonstrate to you now what the tête cassée looks like. You need a properly ironed head square, and you bend it just far enough so that this area can do the circumference of your head. You place the fabric using the markers on your model's head, the eyebrows, and come straight back, making sure that you do not go below the ears. Then you flip one end of the cloth and get your model to pull down. Once you have gathered your fabric, you place the gathered section at the crown of the head. You fix the section on the side, which would have just gaped for you, so that it forms the peak on the side. And then you take the other loose end and tie it in place. So that you have that piece coming down over the wearer's eye. The top piece, you may leave it all together or you may open it out, and you fix the portion on the side so that it forms a sort of a mounting. And this, ladies and gentlemen, is the tête cassée, which can be worn with the Dwiyèt. We also have another form of national wear for our ladies. That's the jupe, the blouse, the skirt, the petticoat, the fuller, and the headpiece. And that is where you have a lot of scope for creating new headpieces and wearing headpieces. One of the headpieces that has taken off really is the butterfly or papillon. And what it is a head square that is folded slightly off center so that the two peaks do not fall directly one on each other. Then the fabric is given a couple folds depending on the size of the head of the wearer. The smaller the head, the more folds you would give. Once you have your headband, then you place again on the head of the wearer and you come straight back, gathering your fabric so that everything is very neat. If you are tying this and you have to save it, then you need to put paper in it. But if you're tying on the wearer's head, then you just, once you've gotten to the back, you just do a simple reef knot, which most people would know from their girl guides and scout days. You tie left over right. You pull up and down. And then you tie right over left. You pull over and through. So there you have the body of the butterfly in the perfect knot. And then you open the wings so that the butterfly can take flight. If you're having a bad hair day and you don't want your naughty boys to be exposed, the butterfly is the perfect headpiece for you. In preparation for doing the shupom or the cabbage, you'd have to create a form for the cabbage, which you will do with newspaper. Then you would choose a fabric that has green for the cabbage or maybe purple and fold your fabric diagonally. Fold one additional sheet of paper to give it a form, to give the fabric additional stiffness. And you insert that in the fold of the cloth. Then you create your fold for your headband. And you place that on your model's head. You will flip the first fold of cloth over your model's face. Make sure that the piece that's lying on your model's head is flat. And then you pleat the paper so that nobody can know that the headpiece has paper in it. And just make sure that it conforms to the shape of the head of the wearer. Once that is done, you place your preformed cabbage round on the person's head and then you pull the cloth over it. You pull the piece from the back. Remember, every loose piece that you have is a cabbage leaf. And you just work with your fabric, making sure that when you crisscross at the back, it is very neat. And using tension to keep everything in place. You can tie to the front or you can tie slightly off center so that the leaves are not all the same length. But while you're doing that, you tend to want to focus on keeping it neat. At all times, you have to be in control of your fabric so that you get exactly what you want. Then you begin to open your cabbage leaves as you want. You may want to keep them open. You may want to make one leaf drop down. Because sometimes, you know, when you look at things in nature, nothing is symmetrical. And as much as possible, use pins that disappear into your creation so that people do not necessarily see that it is pins that has your headpiece standing and holding in place. So there you have the cabbage in the middle and the leaves around your cabbage. Tet shupam, which can be worn by young or old with the jeep or any other creative traditional wear. The Kodmawiyam is one of those headpieces that has become very popular because some people who complain they do not want their heads, their hairstyles messed up and all of that. That is what they choose to wear, and it's very, very easy to tie. You gather about 1.5 to 2 inches from the end. You make sure that everything is even. And then we're going to see the Kodmawiyam, which is really like the yam when it's vining on something. So you use your hand and you just vine the cloth. And you give it some tension so that it stays together. You try to go all the way to the other end until about 1.5 inches of fabric is left. You bring the two ends together. And you get a piece of string, piece of baby ribbon, anything, but not a rubber band, because the rubber band will not give you enough tension so that you can keep it where you want it. And tie very tightly so that you have something that will go around your head and give you a nice rosette to be worn either at the back or on the side. Then you can focus on fixing your rosette before you decide to wear it. Or maybe if you're putting it on somebody's head, you can actually go ahead, put it on, again starting at the forehead and fitting it on the person's head. In this case, I'm going to put the rosette slightly to the side. And then you focus on fixing so that the wearer looks very beautiful. The more you open the flower, the prettier it looks. Just let the fabric tell you where it wants to go and just make it look pretty. Easy to make, easy to wear, and you look very chic and beautifully Dominican. Kodmawiyam in all its glory.